So this week, we're taking a look at a mid-range pen from Cross that sort of looks like something out of a high school graduation catalog. Or maybe it was just my high school that had things like this. Anyways, this is the Cross Calais with a medium nib. Now, Cross markets this as a modern Art Deco-inspired pen, but I'm on the fence as to whether or not they hit that mark. Before we dive in, the back label does have a few interesting things. The first is this lifetime guarantee. The second is information about cartridges that are compatible with the Calais, as well as part numbers for the different Cross ink bottles. Also, don't forget that converter warning. Now, inside the box, we are greeted with a small pamphlet, letting us know that Cross was founded 15 years before the Civil War, and reiterating their unquestionable lifetime warranty against mechanical defects, as well as, you know, never mind, no one reads those. Also in the box is not one, not two, but six proprietary cartridges to help you get up and writing, and I can't recommend them. What I will say is that you should do yourself a favor, spend the extra money, and get this converter. What I feel is a flaw with the cartridge design led me to initially think the pen had a problem, when it was actually the cartridge failing me. And now the most important part of the unboxing is the Calais itself. The presentation is simple, with the pen uncapped to give you a nice look at the nib and section, which I've got to say, that is a pretty long section. Unscrewing the body, we get a good look at the proprietary converter, and once again, third-party ink and converter are sold separately. Also, I've got to say, the converter does offer a fair amount of ink due to how it flares out from the section and into the body. Now, looking at the size of this pen, I'm comparing it to my M600. Capped, the Calais is just under 2/10 of an inch longer than the Pelican, and the barrel diameters are within 3/10 of a millimeter of each other. Uncapped is much of the same. However, the section on the Calais is almost double the length of the Pelican section, and without any threading, it does actually make for a more comfortable grip. Also, the Calais is chunky for its size, coming in at 10 grams heavier than the Peli when fully loaded. Moving on to the writing sample, I'm doing it on Rhodia Blank Pad and using the Miki Black. The original game plan was going to be doing the review with the included ink. After all, it was really cool that Cross included 6 cartridges with the pen, but during that first week, the included cartridge had me thinking the pen was broken. It was hard starting, it was skipping, and it was gunking up. It was around day 6 that I finally just said F this, and bought a converter on Amazon to test a theory, and then put some of the original ink into the converter using a blunt syringe. To be fair, the included ink, if you put it into a converter, is halfway decent. But color-wise and flow-wise, the Miki Black is still a better option. Back to story time though, it turns out that the Cross cartridge has this little ball that slips into the choke point where the nipple pierces the cartridge, and that's all she wrote. You end up in a situation where you have to shake the pen every so often to dislodge that ball and get the flow going again. Honestly, that was really my only bad experience with this pen, but for a person just getting into pens, that could be a deal breaker. Which is sad, because this section is super comfortable, and this nib is awesome out of the box. Once you get a good ink in here, this medium nib is super wet, and it comes out a little bit on the broad side. I'm able to leave this pen out uncapped on my desk for several minutes at a time, and as soon as I come back and start writing, it goes back like nothing ever changed. Also, this nib was somehow smooth upside down, just like it is right side up. So bringing it around to the final thoughts, I know I've been a little hard on the cartridge thing, but honestly, I feel this is a good pen to pen able with. If you shop around, you can find the Calais for less than the $45 that Cross sells it for on their own website. In my case, I was able to pick it up for $28. The converter, or I should say 5 of them, ran $9, and the bottle of the Miki Black was $12. So that's a really decent mid-level pen for $49 that will quickly become a dependable writer. The nib is super smooth and consistent. The body is weighted just right to where I don't feel it affecting the nib pitch one bit. The snap cap, by the way, fits really nice and has a nice tactile feel to it when you're closing the pen. And this pen really does have a nice contemporary feel to it. Is it modern Art Deco? Not so much, at least to me. But contemporary, yes, I'll give it that. So, overall, I'm glad that I didn't give up on this pen, and since figuring out the cartridge issue, this pen actually has become a daily writer for me, and has become my go-to for anything requiring a nice water-resistant black ink, like pen pal envelopes or receipts, and even my monthly rent because I still use a checkbook like a barbarian. That's right, I'm old. I use a checkbook. But that being said, even with its quirks, this is a good pen and easily worth an arbitrary Inkwell 8.7 out of 10. And that's going to do it for the Cross Calais in matte black with rose gold trim. If you liked the video, hit that like button. If you've watched this long and haven't subscribed, maybe give that a go. And if you want channel extras or want to support the channel, I have a Patreon link down below in the show notes. And remember, for the love of God, don't drink the ink.